Who hasn't heard of Shankar? To the common man, Shankar is a synonym of laughter, made possible through his vast number of cartoons and the journals that carried them for ages. For the cartoonist, he was the pioneer of Indian cartooning, who gave a break in their careers as cartoonists in his Shankar's Weekly. To the lovers of art of any age whatsoever, and to the thousands and thousands of children the world over, Shankar's name is familiar through the international competitions for drawing and writing, held annually for children so systematically for over half a century now. To the world of children books, Shankar's name is familiar as one who pioneered children's literature in India. To the children visiting this capital city, New Delhi, from all parts of India, he is familiar as a provider of two biggest attractions for them: a sprawling children's library cum children art gallery, the only one of its kind in the entire country, which displays the colorful prize-winning entries of the drawing competitions held by Shankar annually. And the other biggest attraction, of course, is the highly popular International Dolls Museum for Children, set up by Shankar, with thousands and thousands of exotic, cute and colorful dolls collected by him from different corners of the world. To the writers and publishers, Shankar is known as the provider of the best printing facility with his Indraprastha Press near ITO, Delhi. In short, Shankar is known to many more as an institution providing livelihood for hundreds of workers even today, and as a true pioneer of cartooning that had paved a way and a lifeline for many an upcoming cartoonist. But not as an individual who is merely a lover of children or just another cartoonist who published Shankar's Weekly some time ago. This is a brief and yet an intimate account of this legendary cartoonist and his mission, about which India is proud of celebrating the birth centenary on the 31st of July, 2002.
Shankar cartoon, when I was a student in Trivandrum, I came across his pre-independence cartoons. I will rate him as a preeminent person in the world of cartoons. Even I think the modern cartoonists might have improved the techniques of drawing, but as far as the inner significance is concerned, his insight into politics and his insight into personalities were unrivaled.
Keshav Shankar Pillai was born on 31st July 1902 in Kayamgulam, a small town in Travancore, Kerala, a princely state in South India. Shankaran lost his father when he was still a child. on having distance from his mother also thereafter. He was brought up in the strict but loving care of his granduncle, grandmother and uncle at his native place. His childhood was a happy and a memorable experience for him. Shankar was a born artist and had his fan following at his young age itself. His funny caricatures of his class teachers had embarrassed his school headmaster, but his guardians were amused at his graphic skills. Shankaran had his schooling at Mavelikara, which helped him to develop his personality. He joined in junior BA in 1925 and enthusiastically contributed sketches and articles to the college magazine. Shankar Pillai was graduated with a science degree in 1927. During those days, he met Tankam, a beautiful girl 10 years younger to him, the daughter of an army officer. It was a case of love at first sight. After his graduation, Shankar Pillai proceeded to Bombay to study law but settled in a job instead. He then married Tankam at Trivandrum on 18th May 1931. Independence struggle in India had already gained its momentum by then. Shankar was consciously aware of the state of his country and felt the desire to express his feelings through his natural skills of sketching and cartooning. He dared to lampoon the imperialists who ruled India through his contributions to the Bombay Chronicle, the Free Press Journal, and the Weekly Herald regularly. All his works were highly appreciated even by the British leaders targeted by him. Soon the attention of the then editor of the Hindustan Times, Delhi, Mr. Puthin Joseph, focused on Shankar, and that had led to his final shift to Delhi to join the Hindustan Times Daily in 1932. That was a major turning point in Shankar's life, which started creating a new history altogether. Now, Shankar's cartoons started getting increasingly popular with both Indians and the British. The British viceroys like Lord Wellington, Lord Linlithgow, and Lord Wavell were often the targets of his lampooning, but they all enjoyed his cartoons on them thoroughly. Shankar never spared any of the Indian leaders either. That included even Gandhiji and the female community from the high society. Shankar was blessed with a daughter and a son before he proceeded to London on a year-long tour to study art and the new techniques in drawing. He attended three different drawing schools to specialize in drawing human figure and learned commercial art. On returning home, his work gathered momentum for the nationalist cause, independence for India. A minor disturbing development at his office has led him to resign his job and to start his own publication. India was declared independent. An exhilarated Shankar was inspired to launch his publication, Shankar's Weekly, which the India's first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, had inaugurated in 1948. Panditji had a weakness for cartoons himself, especially those drawn by Shankar. He liked to laugh at them and with them, more so because he was himself often the target of Shankar's pen and brush. He even had told Shankar, "Don't spare me, Shankar," while releasing the first issue of the Weekly, and these words had always remained in Shankar's mind. Panditji took a keen and personal interest in Shankar's work, and to his last days he remained a good and sincere friend and a guide to him. Within a short time of publication of the Weekly, Shankar was recognized as the greatest cartoonist India had ever produced by the eminent as well as ordinary people from all walks of life. Right from the cover page cartoon to the editorial free thinking, the pen portrait of the man of the week, Shankar had caricatured countless number of contemporary international and national personalities and celebrities effortlessly. The endless array of his cartoons covered the contemporary political developments of India with its neighboring countries and with the international community as well. Shankar could easily strike an intimate chord with such eminent personalities as Gobind Ballabh Pant, V.V. Giri, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Atal Bihari Vajpayee and the likes, who wholeheartedly appreciated and enjoyed his cartoons on them and on the prevailing political scenario in the country. On the cartoon characters created by Shankar, there were the Bada Saab and Mame Saab and Mota Chota Ji and Chota Mota Ji that always drew special attention of the readers. Shankar was at the height of his powers as a social and political commentator during Jawaharlal Nehru's prime ministership, which were also the years when the promise of independence was redeemed. I am always drawn to Shankar's cartoons on me because I get an opportunity of self-analysis through them, said Pandit Ji once. Shankar's cartoons rarely have a generalized man. His individuals are real individuals, instantly recognizable in spite of adventurous exaggeration. Shankar's Weekly proved to be a training ground for many of the cartoonists who became famous today in India and abroad. Shankar had always led a very simple and a happy private life and was regarded as a very special person by his family members.
Achyan, as we all called him, is a wonderful human being. He was a dreamer, yes, as everybody has always said, but he achieved his dreams. He reached out to them and he made sure that he achieved them. So he inspired me in so many different ways that eventually I managed to write his biography. He was full of humor. He was moody also, very witty. He loved entertaining people.
One of the biggest attractions for people visiting New Delhi is the Shankar's International Dolls Museum with a small history of its own. Interestingly, a small Magyar doll from Hungary gifted to Shankar had motivated him to start this.
I recall that it was the gift of a Hungarian doll by the then ambassador to Mr. Shankar, and he loved the doll so much that it inspired him to start collecting more and more dolls. And 1, 2, 3, 4, whenever he started going abroad, all he would come back is with loads of dolls. And the children kept waiting that he might get a box of chocolates, but no, it was only dolls. And then when Nehru got to know that Shankar started collecting dolls, every gift that he got from abroad as dolls, he would gift it to Shankarji. And so also did Mrs. Gandhi carry on the tradition, and also her son, Mr. Rajiv. And so the doll collection grew, and today it is from 85 countries, and there are about 6,500 costume dolls, and they're the pride of the trust, Children's Book Trust. Initially, Panditji, Achyan of course very fondly always called him Panditji, he got to know him as a cartoonist first. And then they realized that that they had a common love for children. And it is this togetherness and bonding that sort of made them, think of various means to give more and more and more and the very best to children.
Shankar wanted the people of India, especially the children, to see these dolls. He wanted them to know of the costumes, traditions, culture, and history of the people of those lands from where the dolls came. He also wanted the children of India to be exposed to the greatness and the beauty of the world. Likewise, he also ensured that the children visiting India from far-off lands must also have an idea of the variety of costumes, traditions, and cultures of different states of India. Like, for instance, these colorful brides from Kashmir. And these colorful dolls in their traditional attire on their way to pluck the sweet and tender Kashmiri apples. And of course, these colorful ones from the northeastern states of India. The Indian sari, which is universally popular, is made easy to wear by this interesting set of demonstrating dolls. The people of India who project their unity in diversity, in their castes, colors, and costumes, represent a small world of their own. When it is a national moment, they always join hands and stood on one line, like in this legendary Dandi March, led by great Mahatma Gandhiji, during the days of India's freedom struggle, so lively presented by these dolls. And one can buy these Indian dolls for a small price to preserve or present them as sweet souvenirs.
There were not many authentic Indian dolls available. So he looked around the country, and so he started a doll making workshop, and where costume dolls are made, and it takes a lot of time, but the detailing is perfect, and very, very beautiful dolls are produced there. And the ICCR, in fact, keeps buying dolls from us and orders them to send it across to different parts of the various embassies around the world. They even take a rotating exhibition very often at expos, and the dolls are very popular.
This urge to do something more for the children stirred the sensitive mind of the artist in Shankar, which has culminated in a Shankar's International Children's Competition in Drawing and Writing in 1949, and as a part of it, the Shankar's On-the-Spot Painting Competition in 1952. Panditji had immense pleasure in distributing the prizes to the talented little children by participating in the award-giving celebrations of these competitions without fail as long as he lived.
When he started doing things for children, then there was no end to it. Once the doll collection began, then he said, "I must do something else for children." And he realized that there was a dearth of good books for children. And so, where to get the authors? Where are the children's writers? So, it took some time. And so, he himself began writing. And he has authored over 50 books for children. And one of the most popular ones being Life with Grandfather. And then he wrote the Panchatantra tales, which were very popular. And even today, it's a golden set that is evergreen. I mean, generation after generation have been reading it. It's 50 years since its publication. And so he started, eventually he started getting authors and then illustrators for children. And today, Children's Book Trust is the largest publishing house of children's books in India, with over 1,000 titles and also printed in 10 different languages, Indian languages. Besides, we have also done them in international languages such as Czech, Japanese, Kazakhstan, several others, German also. And they're very popular worldwide. Now, the printing houses were expensive, and so he decided that I must have my own printing press. And that is when he sort of, in his regular meetings with Panditji, and eventually Mrs. Gandhi also, the subject came up, and also alongside the subject also came up about the dolls. Initially, the dolls were going all over the country, you know, as a moving exhibition. And then they started getting bad and soiled. And so Mrs. Gandhi suggested, "Why don't you have a permanent dolls museum in Delhi?" So he says, "Okay, I'm willing. You give me some land." And so Panditji instructed Govind Vallabh Pantji, who was the minister then. And we got this piece of land on which the Children's Book Trust is established. And so along with the dolls museum happening, the printing press came along with it. And today, Indraprastha Press is one of the most distinguished, very, very good printing press of Delhi.
Shankar was the recipient of numerous national and international awards, including Padma Shri in 1956, Padma Bhushan in 1966, and Padma Vibhushan in 1976. Decorations which he received from foreign countries included the Order of Smile from the Committee of Polish Children, Commemorative Medal from the Hungarian Institute of Cultural Relations, and the Order of Saint Fortunate from the Federal Republic of Germany. In 1984, he was conferred the D.Litt by the University of Delhi. The worst setback he had was in the sudden demise of Panditji. And he paid his tribute to that great leader of India by naming his institution as Nehru House. with a daughter and two sons and grandchildren around him, Shankar had a pleasant evening of his life. He perpetually dreamt of doing something more for the children of the world.
I believe to build an international children's center with a large place for exhibition, one hall and the library can be shifted there.
We've almost, the building is has started construction. Sri K.R. Narayanan is our chairman. He laid the foundation stone and work has begun. And we are very, very confident and optimistic that on the 100th birthday of Sri Shankar, which falls on 31st July 2002, the building will be complete.
Shankar closed his publication in 1976 after running it for about 29 years. Shankar passed away peacefully on the 26th December 1989. Yet, his mission continued to be pursued. To honor this great cartoonist of India, the Department of Posts of India has issued a set of 2 commemorative stamps.
This is his last incomplete cartoon. And of course, his mentor, Panditji, was in it too.